Well, hello everyone, welcome to my channel. If this is your first time across my channel, please watch some of my other videos. Hopefully you like them. If you like them, please like and subscribe. This is a video on a vlogging setup for a cell phone. And my cell phone that I'm currently using is a Samsung Galaxy S7. Now, I'm not sure how some of these items work with an iPhone versus an S7 since I have not tried it. Maybe I will try it with my son's phone. But anyways, the stuff that I have here is very inexpensive. I think it's the cheapest I've seen on YouTube. I've checked out a bunch of videos. I haven't seen anything this inexpensive. So anyways, I'm going to do a pan across all the things that I have for this setup. And then I'm going to go through them one by one. All right, here we go. Well, when I was very early in my vlogging times, I had bought a Joby cell phone tripod, similar to this one, but it was close. It was like a GorillaPod, but very small. It ended up being very unsturdy and shaking a lot when I used it. So I went and I got this one here. But I wish I would have saw a video like this before I went off and started buying stuff, because that Joby tripod was like $30, $35. It only lasted me a couple months, and the little gorilla snap-in thing started to break, so I got rid of it. And I bought this thing online for like $7. Well, the top snapped off it, and this leg snapped off. It's just a metal piece, so after bending around poles and everything else for a while, these things will break in half. So do not buy these. This is a learning curve for me. And I hope you guys don't have to deal with it, because tripod no longer works, obviously. This thing snapped right off on me just under regular use. So, but the thing on top here still works for other things. And what I'm filming on right now is a tripod that I bought. I will get to that later, but right now I'm using it to hold this phone up right now. So we're gonna get to that later. This is the other thing I bought. This here was this much. This is exactly what it is. It's a stabilizer. It's got two little magnets right here and here. And you gotta line these up, and you put this in there to keep it from moving around as much, otherwise it moves freely. And you extend this down to make the weight lower, and you put your cell phone up in here. All right, and then you hold it like this and pan across things. It's very limited as to what you can do with it. It's basically for panning, because you can't go up and down, because it keeps it level. So basically, you get your phone centered in here so that the weight hangs straight down. I'll do a cinematic sequence at the end, but you just pan across like this. The rest of the stuff I'm using to make this video, but I'll have to, because I bought a lavalier mic, which is right here, and I will unhook that, and we'll have to talk into the phone itself and not use the lavalier mic while I'm doing the review on this thing, because it requires another tool to make it work in the Samsung Galaxy S7. So here we go. This is with the mic, and this is without the mic. The mic I have here is listed right here. I'm sitting on one side because I'm gonna show you everything I have, where I bought it, and stuff like that. So right over here is this mic right here, the Neer 802. And I found out on my Galaxy S7 that this will not, if I plug this straight into my 3.5 millimeter jack, it will not work at all. You need this tool right here, this little guy here. One side's for headphones and the other side's for your mic. So anyways, this is right here. And so you put this in here, you plug your lavalier mic into the microphone side here, and then you plug this into your phone. Then you just make sure that your volume's all the way up for your media. And then you just put this under your shirt. You can use tape or whatever to hook it onto you. But I'm gonna hook it right here, and then just hide it in here. That way when I turn, I'm gonna plug it back in, be right back. All right, we're back on the lavalier mic now, hidden nicely behind my shirt here. Just got a little clip on it here, and also comes with two windsocks, and it comes with this nice little pouch to put the whole thing in. So that was only $3. I bought two of those because what the heck, you know. Anyways, so that's that. And also on that Y connector that I showed you, it comes with a protector for the 3.5 millimeter jack. And this was probably the second thing I bought, your normal selfie stick. It was $10. Now, with the Gorillapod that I bought, I do not need this anymore, other than taking selfies. If I want to take a bunch of selfies, you know, boom, 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 I don't need this anymore. So you don't need to buy one of these if you don't want to. So I'm not going to add this in the price of everything cost. This was $10. It was cheap, and it's a Bluetooth one. You charge it up here, and this is your Bluetooth button. You just you sync it up to your phone. Boom, you just take pictures wirelessly. Last two things are the Gorillapod and my phone holder. So I got to set this thing up somewhere so I can be able to film this for you. All right. All right. So the last two things I have are this thing right here. Do not go on the cheap one. Go with the one that's this price here. It's got these two really nice indentions here to hold your phone in very nicely. Very nicely. It holds your phone very securely. You don't have to worry about your camera wobbling while you do it. Then I bought this Gorilla tripod. It's a 9-inch Gorilla tripod right here. It's very sturdy. Hold it out there all day. You can keep it steady. You don't have to hold it tight. It's just, you can hold it very loosely, especially with a cell phone on it. You can, and this is actually for a camera. It comes with an adapter screw. I don't have it with me right now. It's at home, because I don't need it for my phone, for this thing here, because it comes with, because it's this size here. But it comes with an adapter to make it bigger for an actual camera. It's a screw that it comes with it on top of. You just take that thing off of here, and it makes it work for one of these. And if you put it on there, it makes it work for the bottom side of a camera. Very sturdy, very nice. All day long, you can do some cinematic stuff with this thing, even if you got a good steady hand. So that's everything. Total price of all this is, so for under $40, you can have a pretty good vlogging setup. Since pretty much everybody has a cell phone, for under $40, you can have a pretty nice setup. Well, let me go ahead and do a little cinematic thing with that stabilizer real quick. I'm gonna do some pan shots maybe up and down. Maybe I'll do a little bit of running. I've only had the thing for about a week. I'm still learning how to use the thing. So sometimes it gets a little wavy like this because I move it too fast. But you know, the idea is to keep it steady like that, and then you can slow it down in your edit and make it look super cinematic. I'm gonna do it without any color grading. All right, here we go. No light in the distance. We were shadows holding on. So I used just what I had to work with here for a little montage there, cinematic sequence. Anyways, for for under $40, you can get all this stuff and get vlogging and make pretty decent vlogs. You just have to have a steady hand, of course, and make sure you don't shake your camera around when you're trying to vlog. Hopefully this video is helpful to people coming or starting new vlogging with their cell phones. I figured I'd make this video, let everybody know exactly what I do here and how I do it. So make sure you share it, no matter what anyone else thinks. Because it's what makes you you. It's what makes you unique. It's what makes you stand out. And it's what makes you awesome. So don't be afraid to sign it and say it with me.
Passion.